alert for this edition of Monday Night Raw. Even miracles fear Brock Lesnar. This Sunday night at Chase Field in Phoenix, Arizona, at the Royal Rumble pay-per-view event, when my client Brock Lesnar puts to bed this ridiculous notion that Finn Balor even belongs in the ring with the Beast, it will be Finn Balor on his back looking up and saying, "Oh my God, I believe in Brock Lesnar."
So Finn Balor versus Brock Lesnar. I mean, I would suggest to you the only way anyone could believe in this is if they believe in the old story of David and Goliath. Remember that one?
I never read the Bible.
This could truly be David and Goliath. You see, let me refresh your memory. One day, David went out into the neighborhood. He ate every single mushroom he could possibly find. And then from there, thought, "I'm going to go up and challenge that big, nasty, mean giant." And he did. And the giant Goliath beat the holy hell out of David. And he was never seen again until he was reincarnated as Finn Balor. If any of you people actually believe that Finn can beat Brock, then you definitely all believe in fairy tales.
You know, last Monday was the worst night of my life, thanks to Baron Corbin. He cost me $100,000, and he cost me my Universal Championship match for you. But saying that, last Monday was the luckiest night of your life as well. So if you still have that Universal Championship after this Sunday, somehow I'll be waiting on the other side. And I'm gonna rip you apart like another one of Mr. McMahon's limousines.
I know you don't believe that I can beat Brock.
I don't believe in fairy tales.
But I believe. And the Balor Club believes. And at the Royal Rumble, I will defeat Brock Lesnar. And I will reclaim my Universal Championship.
Oh, Finn. I know I could have beat Brock Lesnar. I don't know if you can, but you damn well better.
Hey, Braun, thanks for the support. I appreciate it. But really, next time, keep your nose out of my business, because I'm going to do something that you've never done, and that's beat Brock Lesnar. Now, Vince, you got the story a little bit mixed up.
No. I think I had an idea. Don't go anywhere, Brock. I got an idea.
Yeah, that's right. Jog on. Vince, you got the story a little bit mixed up. You see, David, he stood in the shadow of a giant. And they laughed. They said, "You're half the size." And they laughed in his face. But they didn't know who David was. They didn't know what he was made of. And Goliath fell face down into dirt. Boom! No one was laughing then.
Let's have a real life David and Goliath story happen right now. What about it? What about it? Braun Strowman versus Finn Balor. I have a seat. It's going to be very interesting. Let's get her done.
Strowman, of course, distracted by Lesnar, the man he was supposed to face on Sunday. Balor, who won a fatal four-way match against Drew McIntyre and Seth Rollins and John Cena last week. Turn his opportunity! Just swatted away by Strowman. Full head of steam around the ring, and Balor with a sling blade meets Braun Strowman, and suddenly Balor has life.
Suddenly Balor has Brock Lesnar's attention too.
And it seemed to impress Lesnar with that move, the explosive move of Balor. Now what does Finn do? Top rope now by Balor. Braun Strowman though, back to his feet.
385.
And just tossed.
Oh my God.
Lesnar caught Balor and delivered a wicked suplex to the man he faces Sunday. Finn Balor isn't done yet, driving Lesnar into the barricade. Finn Balor putting on a clinic.
Finn Balor is like a man possessed.
Balor Club is present in OKC.
Finn Balor said, I believe. The Balor Club believes. But Balor forgot about Strowman. When out muscles Balor up to the apron. Oh, and Finn Balor tossed halfway across the ring.
Strowman just hit the post so hard, I think the ring shifted.
And Balor gonna drive Strowman into the corner. Finn Balor with a remarkable performance here tonight on Monday Night Raw.
The monster is in the drop zone.
Looking for the coup de grace to put this away. Balor to Strowman.
That's how Balor beat John Cena last week.
And Brock Lesnar now with a message of his own with the F5 to Finn Balor. Well, the bottom line is this. Finn Balor may have been closing in on a victory over Braun Strowman after the coup de grace before Brock Lesnar got involved. And he sent a massive message to Balor with the F5.
I think what we learned tonight is no matter how much momentum Finn Balor can muster up, all it will take is one F5 to stop Finn and the Balor Club.